I'm Coach Colin Costello with Shot Mechanics Basketball, and today we're going to talk about the mechanics behind the Villanova championship game-winning shot. Now, the Villanova-UNC championship game was absolutely phenomenal, and it came down to one huge shot at the end of the game where Villanova was able to capitalize on an open jumper. So today what I wanted to do is I wanted to talk about some of the mechanics that went into that jumper and some of the things that kind of set it up. And so these are things that you can add into your game and probably become a better player just by watching this video. So as I walk you through this play, I want you to think about your own game and your own situations and see how you can apply some of these techniques.
Now, this was an absolute awesome shot. But one of the most underrated parts of a shot like this is the catch. So what Kris Jenkins does on this catch is he does a little something that we like to call ball in the air, feet in the air. Now this is basically just a super simple concept that means you want to time your hop into your jump shot so you're catching the ball with both feet in the air as you're getting ready to come back down. If you catch with your feet in the air, it allows for more upward momentum and that way you can get the ball to the basket easier. Next, let's talk about your landing out of the jump to make sure that you generate that upward momentum. Now I heard a lot of coaches on Twitter arguing about whether this was a hop or a 1-2 step into the jumper, and technically it's 1-2, his feet do come down one at a time, but it's essentially a hop with the motion that he's doing. For me, whether it's a hop or 1-2 is fairly irrelevant, but instead I like to focus that he had his heels up on the landing. This allows for greater spring into the jump shot and thus more momentum and more rhythm. I always like to think about it like jumping off a diving board. Most of the time you're not going to plant your heels in the diving board to get that maximum spring. All right, so Kris Jenkins caught with his feet in the air, landed with his heels off the ground, and now he just needs to transfer the momentum into his jumper. And to really finish off the momentum, he uses a dip. So you'll notice that he catches the ball high up by his shoulders, then dips it lower down by his waist, and then brings it back up into his jumper. Now, just like the backswing on a golf shot, this is the final piece that allows him to get that extra momentum into the jumper. And you'll notice it with this shot, he actually takes it from a long ways out. This is like a beyond NBA range three. So you have those three mechanics together, and what do you get? Probably one of the best shots in college basketball history.
All right, if you feel like this video helped you out, go ahead and hit that like button and then head to the comment section down below that and let me know what sort of video you want to see next. This is a channel for the people, by the people, and I run pretty much everything off a request, so leave it down below and hopefully I'll get to it. All right, if you're new to Shot Mechanics, you're gonna want to do two things. Number one, hit that subscription button down below because we put out a ton of videos every week and they're all gonna get you better, I guarantee it. The second thing you're gonna wanna do is click this button up here or the link in the description, get a free copy of my number one scoring workout. This is a scoring workout that I use with a ton of the athletes that I train, and it's actually one of the fastest ways that you can increase your scoring average. So I highly recommend you check it out, and it's 100% free. Again, I'm Coach Colin Costello with Shot Mechanics Basketball. Thanks for watching, and until next time, splash on.